Hello guys, how are you today? I hope you all are well. My name is Ari and this is Plasticholic TV. Today we're going to talk about Adele. Not that Adele singer, okay? This Adele. Let's go. RGE G1100 Adele. Before we discuss about this kid, it would be good if we take a look at some interesting and important things about this mobile suit. Let's go! RGE G1100 Adele Mass Production General Purpose Mobile Suit. Manufacturer, Earth Federal Forces. Known pilots, Max Hartaway, Alisa Gunhale, and Ryuji Ryuzaki. The RGE G1100 Adele is a mass production mobile suit featured in the anime series Mobile Suit Gundam Age and the mangas Mobile Suit Gundam Age Memories of Sid and Mobile Suit Gundam Age Treasure Star. Adele is a mass production version of the Age 1. The Adele debuted in AG-140 during an attack on the colony of Tordia and started to replace the older RGE C350 Saldol Custom and RGE B890 Genoese 2 unit as the Earth Federation's main unit. In AG-164, the Adele and its variants were deployed by the Earth Federation to counter the assault of the Fagan. The Adele and its variants make up the bulk of the Earth Federation forces defending Rostrolan. Despite the Adele being replaced by the Adele MK2, many Adele units were still deployed by the Federation in AG-164. Armament. Beam Saber. The standard close-range combat armament for most Federation mobile suit. The Beam Saber is a sword-like beam weapon that is used for close combat. It can easily cut through most mobile suit, and the Adele's Beam Saber is based on the Gundam Age 1's Beam Saber. DODS Rifle E. The basic long-range armament that is newly designed for the Adele. The DODS rifle maintains the same strength as that of the Gundam Age 1. And due to the enhancement in its sensors, it omits the precision firing mode, hence increasing cost performance. Shield. The Adele's basic defensive armament. It is a fairly standard shield usually mounted on the left forearm. Guys, this kit is amazing. I'm sure you guys like it. In terms of articulation, this kit is very flexible, making it easier for us to make various poses. Beside that, the joint between the parts are quite strong. For the face or that's in inside the helmet, we can paint it, follow the manual book in black. But for my own, I give it a gray color. But it all depends on your wishes. So overall, this kit is very good. Simple but satisfying. I recommend you to get it. So, happy building everybody!
Guys, thank you for watching. I hope you like what you saw. Before I go, please subscribe to this channel. Smash that like button and thank you for supporting this channel. And I will see you in the next gun plug, next gun then, next action. Bye bye.